guys, welcome back. So today's video is my second video in my at-home experiment series, and I'm going to be testing out different all-purpose cleaners. So in my first video, I tried out different hand sanitizers. So if you want to see that one, I'll put a link down below and you should check that one out. So in today's video, we're trying out three different categories of cleaners. So I have a homemade cleaner that I made by myself, and then I have a more natural kind of cleaner. The brand is Method, and it's their all-purpose cleaner, and it's the grapefruit one. And then the third one is 409, which is a traditional kind of commercial product. I hope you guys like this series, and give it a thumbs up if you do. And let's go ahead and get on to the experiment. So today I have some assistants. This is Alice and this is Atticus, and they're going to be helping me make a very dirty surface. We're going to let this mess dry a little bit, and then we're going to use different cleaners to try to clean it up. All right, Camille, so you're going to be my guinea pig on this test. So what I'm going to need you to do is use 30 seconds to try and clean this mess as quickly as you can. And we're going to have three different products, okay?
Okay.
Okay, we'll start with that. Okay, you've got 30 seconds to clean. Alice, paper towel, perfect. Okay, ready? On your mark, get set, go. Game over. Okay. What do you think?
You know, that's cleaner than I thought it would be based on how it was feeling.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you think of the cleaner overall? Like, did you like the smell? Did you like, was there things about it that you could notice while you're blindfolded?
Now that you mention it, I did notice the smell, but it didn't matter to me either way. It wasn't a harsh smell, but it wasn't overly pleasant.
So I think we need to make another mess.
Yeah.
Another mess, and then we'll start it again. You ready? Okay, let's go. Do you give this video a thumbs up? Yeah. You think it's a good one?
Better than all the stick, 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 sticky, stick. Mom has to clean the lawn.
Okay, so now we are on to round two. We are going to be using this cleaner. Camille has 30 seconds to clean up this mess. So I'm going to go ahead and spray it three times, just like I did last time. That wasn't a very good one. That's kind of weak. Okay. And the time starts now. What's your impression about this cleaner?
I didn't feel like I could clean quite as well with that one.
You felt a difference with the other one?
And I think I didn't like that smell quite as much, but
yeah.
It smelled a little more chemically to me.
Yeah.
But again.
Okay. All right. So we're going to clean this up again, for reals, clean it up, and then we're going to make it dirty, cover it with flour again, and go on to our last product.
It's getting messier.
It is getting messier.
Let's get more water.
More water. More water.
Yeah, water.
Okay.
We'll be right back.
Right back. So, are you ready for round three?
I'm ready.
She's ready. Okay, this is the cleaner we're using in round three. And I'm going to spray it, and then 30 seconds, you guys know the drill. All right, I'm going to give her a spray. Okay, on your mark, get set, go.
Your
partner left.
My partner left.
Your partner's gone.
I think I'll need one more paper towel.
And then we spray.
There you go.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
How'd you feel about that one?
I want to do another one.
Another one? That one felt like it had the strongest chemical smell, and it didn't feel like it scrubbed quite as well. I feel like that first one still did best.
The first one was best. The results, number 3 was
409.
409, a pretty traditional brand. And then we have number 2 was a homemade solution that I made. So this one had lemon and water and essential oils and vinegar. So that's what this one was. And I've been keeping this one in the fridge because it has lemon juice in it. So it's been sitting in my fridge. And then the first one that we did was Method All-Purpose Cleaner. Okay, final thoughts with you, Camille. Which one's your favorite?
This one was my favorite because I felt like it smelled really good and I felt like it cleaned the best.
Okay. Did you feel like there's a difference between these three, or it wasn't, you didn't have enough time to kind of tell, or?
I felt like there was a big difference in smell. This one clearly was like strong chemicals.
Chemically.
So I was surprised that it wasn't just so much easier to clean with it. But other than that, it was, I feel like it's all pretty close to the cleaning, but that one did seem easier.
You do this one again.
Yeah.
Awesome. In this test, we are going to be doing microbial testing using a method called zone of inhibition testing, where we're going to make antibiotic kind of discs that try to prevent growth in our plate. Okay, so I'm putting this bacteria that I got from my sink drain and I'm putting it all over this dish. I'm trying to distribute the bacteria as evenly throughout the whole thing as I can. Okay, so now I'm going to label the back of my dish with the different treatments that we're going to use. Okay, so here are the different zones. So I'm going to place the little pieces of solution-soaked paper towels into these general areas. At first, I wasn't sure if I wanted to make this video because two of my cleaners, the Method and the homemade cleaners, don't advertise that they kill bacteria. They're just like a grease and grime kind of killer. But I was really curious to see if they're doing more than just cleaning the surface. So we'll throw this in here, even though I do know that it advertises on 409 that it can be used to disinfect and sanitize. So I am aware of that. I'm just a little curious. Okay, so I have my control set up. I have my little paper towel and I have about 0.5 milliliters of water in this transfer pipette, and I'm going to go ahead and saturate my paper towel with the water. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and grab this paper towel and place it on the plate under the spot that has the control. So it looks like this. I'm going to continue this process with the rest of my solutions. Okay, so I have all of my little discs or squares in there. So I'm gonna put these in an incubator for a couple of days and then I'll let you guys know the results. It's been 3 days and my plate is finally done and out of my incubator, and I'm ready to share my results with you. All right, let's rewind to when I was preparing this plate. So I got some bacteria swab from my kitchen sink and I ran that all over this entire plate. So let's assume I put nothing on the plate other than the bacteria culture you would expect that it would grow all over the entire plate, it would all be covered. However, when I put the little pieces of paper towel that had the different solutions in them and place that on the gel, that kind of diffuses to the gel, and if they have an effect on the bacteria growth, then you'll end up seeing these kind of zones around the paper towels. And that's exactly what we see in our little experiment. Let's go through the different treatments and discuss which ones did the best. My control was water, and there was no zone around my paper towel, which means it had no effect on bacterial growth. The next treatment was Lysol, which did create a nice zone. 409 also created a zone, and so did the method cleaner. My homemade solution didn't create a true zone like the other cleaners, but it was more effective than our water control. You can figure out which cleaner worked best by how large the zone is. However, in my case, my paper towels weren't spread out enough, so I have some overlap in my zones, and there's some uncertainty on which cleaner performed best. The only clear result I have is that the store-bought cleaners were better at preventing bacterial growth than my homemade cleaner. It is important to note in my results that this is only the case for the bacteria that grew in my kitchen sink. Different cleaners are meant for different purposes, and you should only use them for their intended purpose. For example, method cleaner did really well in my test, but that doesn't mean it will be just as successful as Lysol in killing viruses or other types of bacteria. All right, that's all I have for today's video. Subscribe to my channel if you want to continue watching my at-home experiment series, and make sure to hit that like button. Thanks so much for watching. Stay smart, stay safe, and we'll see you next time.